Welcome back to Frac Daddy BBQ. I'm Jared. On today's video, I'm going to show you how to restore and reseason your Blackstone griddle. Now, if you live somewhere that's very humid, you may know that your griddle is going to rust over time. Mine got out of control, so you know what? I'm fixing it today. So, we're going to take you outside, show you how bad my griddle is, and then we're going to make it looking like new. As you can see, this griddle is in horrible condition. You know, I love my cast iron, and I take care of my cast iron. So I'm going to get this looking like my cast iron. Let me take you inside, and I'll show you the tools we got to make it happen. Okay, so you might be wondering, Frac Daddy BBQ, what did you go get to restore your Blackstone griddle? I'll tell you what I went and got. I went to Walmart, and in their outdoor section, they have this Blackstone cleaning kit. So a few months ago, we went and bought one for Melissa's sister's husband. He asked me, hey, can you restore my Blackstone? Because my seasoning is coming off when they cook. They're getting black flakes on their food. So I said, sure, why not? We went over there. It took us about an hour and a half to do it. So what this kit comes with a scouring pad, which you're going to need for the oil, your stone to help get your rust off, and then a scraper to get everything loosened up after you do your first step. Now, what you're also going to need, you're going to need some old rags, you're going to need some oil, and then when you start your seasoning process, flaxseed oil is highly recommended for doing your Blackstones or cast iron or grapeseed oil. It may be expensive, but you know what? It's worth it if you want your cast iron or your Blackstone to last. So let's go outside and we're gonna show you the first step that we're gonna do. Okay, so step one, wipe off any debris that you have on your Blackstone. So we're gonna go over here, we're gonna light it up, and they recommend do a medium to high heat for 30 minutes. So let's go. Perfect time, while your griddle is clean after you just wipe it down with water to go over and see if you missed any spots. And if you did, just take your stone, a little bit of oil, scrub it to your liking, and you'll be happy. Here we have our flaxseed oil. We are going to kind of give a nice thin layer on this, and then we're going to turn it on and we're going to heat up. Now, you don't want to have an abundance of oil because your seasoning won't happen properly. It will just sit there and burn, and you kind of want a thin layer like you're going to put on your cast iron. I'm going to do a little more because my rag soaked up quite a bit of this. Make sure you get every inch, the sides, because this is all bare metal. Light it back up to a medium to high heat, and we're going to do it for 30 minutes. Okay, so as you can kind of see, like right here and right here, your griddle is starting to kind of get like dark spots, and that's exactly what you want. Your oil is burning in to the metal. Now we're going to repeat this 3 times, and then on the last one we'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so, and another tip, after your first burn in, let it cool down for about 10 to 15 minutes and then repeat with the same amount of oil, a nice thin layer. And like I said, do that for a total of 3 times. So I just got done adding a little bit of oil to finish it off. Now, if you have a Blackstone that looked like mine, please follow these steps because they work. If you have any questions, you can email me at fracdaddybbq@gmail.com, or you can hit me up on Instagram. And also, if this is your first time coming across my video, please like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know when Frac Daddy BBQ puts out some more videos. Oh, a little FYI, we're going to be making homemade burgers tonight for a video we're going to be shooting tonight. So, stay tuned for that video if you want to see how this works.